So this is part three of our introduction to financial accounting, terms, principles, and the accounting equation. And this part will be covering the revenue recognition and the matching principles. So the first one we'll look at is the revenue recognition principle. As we all know, earning revenue is the purpose of doing business. And revenues are created by doing the day-to-day activities that our business was created to do. What the revenue recognition principle says is we should record revenues when they are earned, not necessarily when cash is received. Now, I have necessarily in italics here because you can earn revenue at the same time you are given the cash for performing a service or selling a product. So just remember that revenues are recorded when they are earned, and not necessarily when cash is received. So let's look at an example where we earned revenues of $5,500. And we're going to look at it two different ways. The first way, we're going to say, okay, let's say we earned these revenues and cash was received immediately when those revenues were earned. And then the second way we'll look at it is we earn them on account and we'll receive it later, receive the cash later. So let's go to number one. And so we earn these revenues and receive the cash. So how would that affect our accounting equation? So first let's recall our accounting equation. Assets equal liabilities plus owner's equity. And let's determine what parts of the accounting equation are getting affected here. Well, we're receiving cash. Cash is an asset. So assets are going up by the $5,500. What else is happening? Are we incurring a liability here? No, we're earning revenue. So what we have to remember, well, revenues affect net income by increasing net income. Net income affects retained earnings, and retained earnings falls under the owner's equity section. Therefore, revenues will make retained earnings go up, thereby making owner's equity increase by $5,500. And now our accounting equation balances. Let's look at the other scenario. We earn the revenues on account, which means we'll get paid later. So let's think again how this will affect the accounting equation. Are assets being affected? Well, cash isn't being affected here because we're earning it on account. But there is an asset being affected, and it's called accounts receivable, money that we're owed. So our assets are going up by the same amount, $5,500. Are our liabilities changing? We don't owe anyone money. We earned revenue here. Again, owner's equity is increasing because our revenues are increasing. Again, revenues affect net income. Net income affects retained earnings. And retained earnings is an owner's equity account. Let's look at the second principle. Incurring of expenses. Expenses, as we know, create revenues. You've heard the old saying, you have to spend money to make money. Well, what the matching principle tells us is that expenses are recorded when they are incurred, not necessarily when cash is paid. So again, I put necessarily here in italics because we could incur an expense and pay it immediately. So expenses are recorded when incurred, not necessarily when cash is received. So let's look at another example. We incurred rent expense of $16,500. And again, we'll look at two scenarios. We paid cash immediately when the rent was incurred, or we got the bill and we're going to pay it later. So the first one is cash. We paid it immediately. How does that affect the accounting equation? Well, does it affect assets? If we pay something, it affects cash. Cash is an asset. So assets are going down by the $16,500. Are liabilities affected? We're not incurring a liability here. We don't owe someone money in this case because we're paying this bill immediately. So it doesn't affect liabilities. Well, what about owner's equity? We're incurring an expense. Recall that expenses decrease net income, so they affect net income. And net income affects retained earnings. And retained earnings is found under the owner's equity section of our accounting equation. So owner's equity is decreasing by that $16,500. Now let's look at the scenario under incurring it on an account. So let's see how that will affect our accounting equation. So again, our assets being affected in this case. Let's look at this scenario as if it's happening right now. Assets are not being affected. However, we owe this money. We're going to owe this money in the future. So for right now, liabilities are increasing. We owe that money. What else is happening? Well, owner's equity is still going down because we're incurring an expense, and expenses decrease net income. Net income affects retained earnings, and retained earnings is part of owner's equity. So it's making owner's equity go down. And even though nothing happened on the left-hand side of the accounting equation, we still balance. There was no change to the accounting equation at all because the right side went up by $16,500 and it went down by $16,500. So there's no change there. Well, if this is what happened today, right now, what will happen in the future when we pay this bill or pay off this rent expense? So let's look at what will happen in the future. Will assets be affected? When we pay out money, cash is affected. That's cash. That's an asset. So assets will go down by that $16,500. Is liabilities affected? Yes, we no longer owe that debt because we're paying it off. So our liabilities are also going down by $16,500. And owner's equity is not being affected here because we're just paying off a debt. And as you can see, our accounting equation still balances.